You lazy fucker.
Alright, don't shoot me. I was only asking a question. Apparently, Mussolini has cancelled civil rights for Jews in Italy.
Oh, that bastard. Someone ought to shoot him.
Exactly. What a dirty bastard.
Alright, Fergus, dinner's ready.
Have you heard, Jimmy Arlo?
What's that, Fergus?
I've read in the papers that Hitler has annexed Austria.
You're joking.
No, they think he even maybe invade England.
Anyways, Fergus, what are you getting Agnes for Christmas?
Well, Jimmy, money's very tight at the moment. It's hard to find two pennies to rub together. I really want to get a necklace.
Don't worry, Fergus. I've got you covered.
Jimmy, you're a lifesaver. What do you want for it?
Nothing at all, Fergus. It's on the ass. Now run along before I change my mind.
Sorry, love. Due to money this year, I didn't get you anything.
Don't worry, love. Having you here is enough.
Oh, Fergus, you soft fucker.
Anyway, close your eyes and hold out your hands.
Why?
Just do it.
Oh, Fergus, it's beautiful. Where did you get it?
I have my ways.
I am speaking to you from the cabinet room at 10 Downing Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently, this country is at war with Germany.
Well, that's it then.
Don't worry, I don't think they'll even look for anyone here.
Are you sure, darling?
No matter what, Fergus, I'll stick with you through and through.
Shit, Fergus. Did you hear Chamberlain's speech the other day?
I did, Jimmy. Do you really think we'll get called up?
I'm not sure, Fergus. I'm not sure.
Fergus, what's that noise?
I'm not sure, dear.
Well, go and look, you silly fucker. What is it?
It's a British officer.
What's he doing here?
He's coming to the door.
Hello, I need to speak to the man of the house.
I am he.
Good afternoon, I'm Officer Bridwell of the 1st Battalion of Soldiers for Great Britain. And I understand you haven't been called up yet, have you?
No, sir, I haven't.
Well, my boy, today is your lucky day. You can go to the front line and fight for king and country.
Really?
Don't worry, my lad, we'll have you home in no time once we sort out here that god-awful Nazi party.
But Fergus, what am I to do without you? Have you not heard the news of the thousands of dead soldiers?
Best leave you to your affairs. Be back for you in a week or two. Tally-ho.
I don't know, Angus, what to do. I'm backed up into a corner. But should we go to the cinema and get our minds off it and have a real farewell?
Maybe we can go and see that new Wizard of Oz film.
Somewhere over the rainbow. you dare to dream really do come true.
Just fingers me as Dorothy from Oz is going to find the wizard.
Because I love you all. And, oh, Annie M, there's no place like home.
Wake up, dear, the movie's finished.
Telegram as soon as you get to France.
I will.
And you've got the sandwiches I made for the way over there?
I have.
Oh, Fergus, I'm really going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you too, but I'll still be here with you in spirit, dead or alive. I'll be out there in 1 minute. Remember, I'll always be here for you when I'm gone.
Oh, Fergus.
Come out, walk to the door. Guess this is farewell. Bye, love. Make sure you look after the house. I'm gonna miss you.
Bye, Fergus, love. See you soon.
You will. You will.
Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do. Till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know. Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing.
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.